Hi, I'm going to take a class about operational amplifier. Before going to start the classes, operational amplifier, what it will do? It will do the simple operation of addition, subtraction, integration, like simple mathematical operations. Now we will discuss about the ideal operational amplifier. And usually we know this operational amplifier is made up of many transistor, diodes and resistors, even capacitor in an integrated circuit technology. This operational amplifier is characterized by, it should have input impedance is infinite, the input infinite gain for a differential input, and we have it should have a zero output impedance and infinite frequency bandwidth. If you see the circuit symbol for an operational amplifier, the plus symbol is indicated as a non-inverting input, and minus symbol indicated as an inverting input. So the supply V1 is given to non-inverting input, and V2 power supply is given to inverting input, and our output V0 is AVL of V1 minus V2. And this is our equivalent circuit for an ideal operational amplifier. That is, open loop gain is very large. So the equivalent circuit for an ideal operation can be modeled by voltage controlled source with a very large gain AOL, known as open loop gain, and feedback reduces the gain of an amplifier. And these ideal op amp has no non-linear distortion. The real op amp must have a DC supply, which is often not shown in a schematic. Usually, fourth pin is connected to minus V, and seventh pin is plus V. It is voltage DC supply voltage. Now we go for inverting amplifier. The main difference between inverting and non-inverting is the feedback. Okay. Now the operational amplifier are almost always used with the negative feedback. That is an important one, negative feedback. Part of our output symbol is returned to the input with a negative sign. Now, these feedback reduces the gain of an operational amplifier. Since operation amplifier has a large gain, even a small input produces large output, thus for a limited output voltage. So the input voltage must be very small. And practically we set Vx, that is the difference between the two terminals, voltage potential difference between inverting and non-inverting should be a zero. That is plus V and minus V should be a zero. The potential difference between inverting and non-inverting terminal should be a zero. Now we'll discuss the you see the diagram. Vx, that is a difference, voltage difference between inverting and non-inverting terminal. Now we will give a Vn, that is potential difference is connected to a non-inverting terminal, and inverting that is plus is connected to ground. So our Vx should be zero, that is both terminal values should be equal. That is voltage at the inverting terminal that is equal to voltage at a non-inverting terminal. With the Vx is 0, usually I1 that is equal to I2, and these should be a 0, then only will our Vx will be 0. If it is Vx will be 0, we will get some higher output voltage. So I2 that is equal to I1, and V0 equal to minus I2 R2 that is equal to minus Vn R2 by R1. So the gain AV value that is equal to V0 by Vn equal to minus R2 by R1. Okay, next, since V0 equal to minus I2 R2 that is equal to minus Vn R2 by R1, thus the output impedance of an inverting amplifier is 0, then the input impedance is R1 as Zin, that is equal to Vn by I1 equal to R1. Next, inverting amplifier with higher gain. Inverting amplifier gain V0 equal to, usually we know minus I2 R2 equal to minus Vn R2 by R1. It is limited to fact that it is hard to obtain a larger resistance ratio, right? So higher gains can be obtained in the circuit below, where we have I1 that is equal to Vn by R1, right? That is equal to I2. So we know I1 equal to I2. So from KCL at node N2, we have I2 plus I3 equal to I4. Sum of the incoming current equal to outgoing. Right. So okay. Now, right. Finally, I2 plus I3 equal to I4, and I4 is minus V0 minus I2 R2 by I4. Apply Kirchhoff's law. If you apply Kirchhoff's law, that is I3 equal to I2 R2 by R3. So, and we have, if you substitute I2 plus I2 R2 by R3 equal to minus V0 minus I2 R2 by R4. So from this equation we can find out the values. Substituting these I2 equal to Vn by R1 in this equation, we can get a V0 by Vn that is equal to minus R4 by R1 into 1 plus R2 by R3 plus R2 by R4. So if you choose R1 and R3 value is 1k, and the R2 and R4 value is 10k, right? We can find out the voltage gain, that is AV is minus 120. That's, so we seen here our gain value is very large, right? Next we will see the positive feedback. When we flip the polarization of the op amp as shown in the figure, we'll get a positive feedback that saturates the amplifier output. It should not be done. Okay, now comes to non-inverting amplifier. The one difference between the inverting and non-inverting amplifier is, in non-inverting amplifier, the input source should be connected to plus terminal, and the feedback from the output should be given to a negative terminal. So this is the difference between inverting and non-inverting amplifier. So usually we know V1 that is equal to Vin. It's between plus and minus the voltage created, between plus and minus that is equal to input source. So V1 equal to Vin, and I1 value is V1 by R1, I2 is minus I1. Right, so from these we can calculate the AV value. So AV equal to V0 by Vn equal to 1 plus R2 by R1. Okay, this one. We can now we can see some exercise finding the voltage gain AV, that is AV equal to V0 by V1 and input impedance. For two conditions, one switch is open and switch is closed. From, if you see the diagram, from KVL, Vn equal to I1 into R plus I1 equal I1 into R plus V0. Right. So if you open the circuit, our I2 value will be a 0. And I1 into R, that is equal to I2 into R. So usually your I1 value will be a 0. So if it is I1 value is 0, then definitely our V naught that is equal to Vn, and your AV value will be a 1. Okay, it's a simple exercise.